Hello all. So let's continue with the next part of this tutorial. So let's get started. So as we have seen this car modeling over here, we have done some tweakings. I'll just hide this. Let's unhide all. And I have just trimmed it to do some adjustments with it over here. So I'm again just pushing it back right to its place where it was before. So I'll off this symmetry. So this is a different element. Definitely this is also a different element. So I'll just go into the edge. So it's more important, like you select this and attach it with this. Now again I will just go over here and I will just select it. Press Ctrl and select it, and I'll just bridge it. So I'll get right back to its original shape over here. So what tweakings I have done over here is, like, I have done some changes for the headlamps. So if you see the headlights over here, I have just worked on it to give it a proper look over here. So let's select this also, and from the side view also I need to select this stuff. If you need more selections, you can go for it, but yeah, perfect. So after you're done with this, let's go to the top view and let's see the selection what we have made over here. That's the right selection we have done over here. Now, what I can do over here is, like, insert it, just insert it over here. So let's go into this vertices, select this vertices and just push this down. So I'll select this, both the vertices, and I'll just push this down. I'll select this and I'll just push it in front of it. So select this lights over here and let's extrude it. If I extrude it inside, so just undo it. Now, for the lights, what I can do is, like, I have two things over here. First, we'll just give a color to it. So now that's a bigger area, as you have seen as before. Now that looks much better than the previous lights, the bigger lights over here. So let's go over here and let's give a symmetry modifier again into the x-axis. Make it as a symmetry. I'm sorry, make it into z-axis. And just push this over here, right on the top. Now, what I can do over here is like, I'll just push this a bit in front. Just push this to the side a bit. Yeah, now looks much better. So let's remove the symmetry modifier over here, and same as you can just remove the knobs toggle as we are working over here. Save your file. Now what I want over here is like, I'll again go back to the front view and let's make some changes over here. As like, I'll just push this over here, I'll select this center and I will just scale it. So press R and let's go to the top view and scale it. So as you can scale and make it a bit more straighter. That's more, much straighter, better. Alright. Now I'll just come back over here. So if you have the back view, you can utilize the back view. We can check out if we have a back view over here. So let's check out the back view for that. Ref car. I have just this. Oh yes. So you have the back view of this car. So you can just check out this reference, that how it looks like for now. So if you see this in the max file, if you see the back view, need to do work more on the back view part. So if you have more extra loops, you can easily remove those loops if they are not really required. You can really remove those loops if they are really not required. So let's again go back into the view over here and let's activate the symmetry option. Let's go into this polygons and let's use a bit of extrude. I don't need to extrude it, I want to use a bit of inset and just extrude it inside and select this and just delete it. Select this and just delete it. Just select this and delete it. And let's make it as a symmetry over here. So I'll again select this and I'll scale it and make it much straighter. From my side, let's go into the vertices and adjust this a bit down. select this and just push it up it inside, push this inside. Now what I can do over here is, like, if you again see this, we have some kind of a exhaust also over here. We are going to just push this stuff up it inside. I'll just extrude it inside over here. And let's go over here, select this polygons and just extrude it down like this. You can just push this down. And just push it inside. Save your files. So select this again, select the polygons and again use a inset over here. Select this and definitely delete this stuff, this and this. I'll off the symmetry, I don't need a symmetry for now. I'll just delete this stuff. I'll go into the vertices and again I will push this into the center. And I'll take a swift loop over here. I'll just push this in this way. And I will use a symmetry back again. And for the tail light, so we can just pull this element out a bit by using this push and pull option. So I'll just reduce its strength. And also, we have one more option over here. You can just pull this out if you want. So increase the size of the brush again and push this out. And if you want, you can just use a bit of a relax if you want. And if you want to check it how it looks like, you can just check this. Alright. So remove this knobs toggle over here. And for the handle over here, we are definitely again creating one loop over here. So let's take one loop over here. Let's go into this polygon and what I'll do over here is like I'll just insert it. So I'm using insert a bit, not much for now. Next thing is I'll just push this up, I'll just push this down in this way, and I'll use a bit of bevel a bit, and I'll just click OK. That's it. Alright, for the handle stuff. So let's go into the front view. So let's give a bit of thickness to it. Sorry. Crashed. Let's open it again. All right. Let's open that file back. So again select this polygons and let's extrude it inside, or we'll just extrude it a bit out. Or else what you can do is you can also use a bit of shell modifier. If you want to use a shell modifier to the car, you can use a shell modifier, not much, but you can give a bit of shell. And if you go into it and give a mesh smooth, so that also looks good over here, much better. So I'll off the symmetry. And now I want to create this stuff. So for that, what we'll be doing over here is like I'll just use a plane over here. So let's take a plane over here and just increase the length and width segments of the plane, and let's push this plane over here. So I'll just rotate a bit, I'll rotate the plane a bit over here, I'll push it in front, again I'll just rotate it, not much. Alright, so we have a modifier over here, that's a lattice modifier. So we are going to use a lattice modifier over here. Let's go into the lattice and just reduce this over here, go down. And reduce this radius. So it's like I'm making it as 0.02. It's too high. Still, it's too high. 0.05. The strut radius, you need to reduce the this radius 0.2. I'll make this 0. I'll make this as 0. So 0.008. Still we need to reduce it. I'll go down 0.008 0 0.2. 0.008 0.005 0.002. All right, and over here 0.002 0.005. I think we need to increase this radius, that's the strut 0.005, much better, and let's make this a 0. This is, I think, perfect over here for this. Alright, so now if you see this, it's the right stuff which we have done over here. So select this and let's just give a material. We'll give a area material. Let's give a black material over here. Same for this also. Just save your file. Let me save my file once again. So, R_5. And let's go over here and activate this. Select this. And definitely we are going to again create a symmetry of it. Let's make a symmetry. Just push this over here. And rotate it. This way. Much better. Alright. So basically. Alright. So we'll continue the rest of the part in the next tutorial. Thanks for watching this tutorial.